Okay, we just had to do an update on Simba because when we were here about a little over a month ago, he was so scared and confused. We didn't even want to put a bandana on him. We were afraid we'd stress him out. He just needed some chill time here at the kennel, and he has completely turned around. I'm going to have Leela talk in a minute, but all the volunteers that come on the weekends to walk the dogs have commented how he's just turned into such a... Look at that smile. I have the saddest pictures of him online. He's the most pitiful face. They said he's just happy and waggy and playful. So why don't you tell me some of the stuff you're talking to earlier about?
Yeah, he's turned out to be really great. He's really friendly. He's social. He loves to be around people. He just adores Brandon, which everybody knows Brandon. He loves to play ball. He will fetch it and bring it back to you and just play and play and play.
Aww.
And he goes nuts every time he sees Brandon. He just wants attention. He wants to be out. He wants to play. When we first got him, he was really scared and timid and would go in his doghouse and not come out, but he's warmed up to everybody really well. He's just doing great. His skin is clearing up really nicely. He's all around a really good dog. He'd make a family a really great companion. He's super sweet.
And really deserves a chance. As you know from his old video, he had been basically living in a cage in a basement. The relative of the people who owned him, she was very sweet, though. She has written to me several times wanting to know how he's doing, and we're so grateful that we took him in because she knew that wasn't a good situation for him. So look at him, though. We've seen a smile on his face, and he just looks at Leela and smiles. He looks like he might eat a cookie.
Yeah, he's really good.
He looks like he's had quite a
He looks. That's what I'm thinking too. So you never met a cookie you didn't like? Do you know Sid? Simba, sit, sit.
He does sit. He does.
Good
shake.
Boy. Do you know shake? Shake. Good boy. Good boy. Oh, and his nose is a little raw. She said from at the edge of the cage.
He doesn't care for other dogs, so he kind of likes to fence fight just a little bit.
Okay.
But other than that, he's super sweet. He'd have to be an only dog unless he found a female maybe that he liked. But
okay.
Yeah, he's really sweet. And he's
just
as cute as he can be.
He sure is. He just has the sweetest eyes. I love those sweet brown eyes. He's a very cute boy. So we just want to get a little update, show everybody how well you're doing, how much you've come around. And this is Simba. Give us a kiss. Okay, this is Simba. Simba is about 4 years old. We're gonna take it real easy today. He's pretty nervous and scared. A lot of new stuff going on for him. So we wanna give him some time to just kind of chill out and learn that people are on his side and people mean good things. I don't think he's been mistreated. I think he's been kind of ignored. I will say, I want to make very clear, the lady I worked with to get him here, she could not have been nicer. She was very cooperative. He was not her dog. She was just trying to help him out of a tough situation. In short, he has basically spent the last 2 years living in a crate in the basement, getting out only to relieve himself and not a lot of interaction. I'll just read from her notes here, and every time she mentions the crate, it's the answer to a lot of the questions. She said that the way he came into the family, her brother-in-law got him from a friend when their dog had puppies. She said, he was originally my sister's. She was unable to keep him due to where she was living and had him stay at my parents' house. She was supposed to take him back after she got into a home instead of an apartment, but that has not panned out. My parents are unable to care for him in the way he needs, and he spent most of the past 2 years in a cage in the basement. He would love to be around family. He can be very playful. He loves running and playing catch or tugging on a rope. He tends to be very protective, and she said he's scared of strangers, will bark and growl. Well, I don't think he's had much interaction or socialization with anybody. She said he interacts well with the adults he knows from the family and he's around them. He's not been trained off the leash. Well, we don't even want to talk about that because none of them should be off a leash anyway. He has a high prey drive, will run for a squirrel or bird. He's very strong. He's been around children ages 2 to 17. Tends to interact well with the older kids and or teenagers. He enjoys going on walks with my 14-year-old nephew. He's jumped on the younger ones and barked, and that scares them. She says again, he enjoys running, playing catch, and tug of war with his rope toy. I have played with Simba in the yard when he used to be leashed in the yard. My sister has taken him to parks where there are open field areas. She goes on to say, my nephew and sister have taken him on walks periodically, whatever that means. He spent a day at my other sister's house with her dog and their neighbor dog, both males and smaller. He was not aggressive toward them and seemed to enjoy playing with them in the yard. He's also been babysat by a family friend that has a large male dog and small female dog, and he played well with them too. If an unknown dog comes by the house, he will run toward it but just sniffs at it. He is not safe with cats. He had one encounter with a cat, which no harm came to the cat, but that was because they interfered. So he's not cat friendly. She said he lives, we asked if they are indoor or outdoor dogs. She said, Simba lives indoors. He has been mostly caged for the past 2 years. That's half his life, by the way. He only spends time outside when he's taken outside to potty. He also gets to go outside when he's taken to the vet or to be kenneled for a weekend. Periodically, my nephew will take him for a walk around the block. We ask, where does he sleep? She said, he sleeps in the cage. Where does he stay when they're home? In his cage. Where does he stay when they're not home? In his cage. She said he had great trained, apparently. Said he's housebroken. I guess he doesn't have a choice. Said Simba has not allowed to be free since he was a puppy. When he was a puppy, he chewed on things. They didn't have a fence. We don't know about escaping. So he's been kept on a leash outside. We asked about training. She said he's had no formal training. How does he behave on a leash? He pulls on a leash, does well in the car, enjoys sticking his head out the window. He doesn't like loud noises, strangers, and he gets anxious when he's taken to the vet. Well, this is a dog that I think is just in total sensory overload right now. I mean, he's been isolated. You heard how many times the answer to the question was his life was in a cage in the basement. So he's going to need somebody that he can learn to trust. I have an idea. We've had some scared ones here before. They tend to come around pretty quickly. We have good volunteers who teach them people are nice and, you know, good things come from people. And again, I don't think he's been mistreated. I just think he's been stuck away and not had a lot of chance to have social interactions with, you know, except for a very few people. Everything in his world has changed now. He lived in that cage and all of a sudden now he's at the kennel with other dogs, with people he doesn't know handling him. We're not sure what his mix is. We're calling him Husky Mix. We both think that that face, the adorable face, and those big ears look kind of corgi. Well, you can see when he perks them up, they kind of go forward. He has such a pretty, pretty face. So this is kind of an initial video for him. We'll probably be updating down the line after he has a little chance to get settled in and figure out who he is. So, and he does have some kind of irritation on his rear end, which you maybe saw then. Of course, we'll get that taken care of at the vet. So I'm not gonna come too close to him right now because he needs to get used to us. Hey, Simba. Hey, buddy. It's all going to be okay. We'll give you some time. We'll find a wonderful home for you. You're going to make a great dog for somebody. Who can't fall in love with that face? Good boy. Show you petting him and him doing okay with you petting him. I'm filming right now if you want to pet him. That's a good boy. Yeah, that's just been a few minutes. He's like, that lady's nice. She's petting me and it feels good. It's okay, buddy. It's okay. We're not gonna push you.